welcome back to Hack It Out, and this is number 3 of the Banjo-Tooie playthrough. All right, so previously we were, we just started in Mayhem Temple, got 5 of the 10 Jiggies here, and now we are going to resume. Okay, so we just got this Jiggy up here at the top. Now, I will tell you that we're not going to be able to get all 10 Jiggies right away, because there is one thing this game does is backtracking. So there is a Jiggy in here that we will not be able to get until after we go to World 2. I believe it's the second world. Yeah, it is. World 2, once we learn a certain move there, then we can come back here. That's kind of a trick. I did it kind of poorly, but anytime you stop in front of one of these signposts, the very first time that kind of animation there starts up where a jam jar is just telling you what the signpost is. And so that's a trick, especially if you're wanting to speed run. Whenever you're up there at that platform that I was just on, like that one right there, it's actually right where that treble clef was that I got in the last video. If you want to quickly come back down here, as soon as you grab that treble clef, you can jump off the cliff, and as long as you aim it to where you land right in front of the signpost, then it will not give you any damage because that animation will kick in. So it's a little trick there for you. All right, let's go fly over here. There's a Jinjo up here I want to grab. Oh, Mr. Green. Alright. Let me go over here to this little temple over here. I told you guys I was going to try to be a little bit more prepared this time around. And I am, so I at least know what I want to go get in the order and stuff. So I'll get this Cheeto page. Well, really, that was a mistake. I should have gone in here first to open up that top door and then got the Cheeto page, because then I could have just went right in. So, so much for that. Anyway. This guy's name is Bloatizen. Chief Bloatizen, to be exact. He's lost a relic, and he's really worried about it. Target Zan's gonna get mad at him. Target Zan is the, he's the boss of this world. Yeah, so see, he opens up that door. I should have waited, and I could have got that Cheeto page then. But anyway, we gotta find this relic for Bloatizen. Get the honeycomb piece while I'm in here. We gotta get the relic for Bloatizen, and then he'll give us a Jiggy. So I'll go ahead and take care of that now, because that'll take care of the easy Jiggies of this world. Then what I'll have left to do is I'll have to do the kickball tournament, which can be frustrating, but there's actually 2 versions of the kickball tournament in this game. One in this world and then one in world 8. I think it's world 8. I get some of those later worlds, I kind of get them backwards. It's Hailfire Peaks. I believe that's world 8, because there's 9 worlds in the game. Let's see, Mayhem Temple is 1. Glitter Gulch Mine is 2, Witchy World is 3, Jolly Roger's Lagoon is 4, Pterodactyl Land's 5, holy crap, what's after Pterodactyl Land, holy crap, Grunty Industries, would be 6, that would make Hailfire 7, then 8 Cloud Cuckoo Land, that can't be right. I'm distracting myself because I'm trying to play and trying to think of that at the same time. Gosh, for those of you who know much about Banjo, you're probably really thinking I'm a big old idiot right now. Especially if I did leave one off. For some reason, I was thinking this had 9 worlds. Unless it's counting the very last thing, Cauldron Keep, as a world, which it shouldn't be, because I mean, it's not really a full world. Let me think here. I just gotta pause this to think. Jolly Rogers, Pterodactyl. Yeah, I think there's no way I'm missing one. I'm right. There's 8 worlds. And then I guess you could say Cauldron Keep is 9. Anyway, for those of you who don't know much about this game, you're probably like, what the heck am I even talking about? Anyway, in Hellfire Peaks, there's a much harder version of the kickball tournament. And that's one I usually skip, but if I'm doing a 100% playthrough, I will give it a shot. But I can just tell you right now, ooh, you might see some of my anger in that one. Okay, so technically we kind of just walked into world 5. That's what I love so much about this game is all these worlds. It's not so linear. I mean, it is like there is a certain order, but the worlds are so interconnected. But anyway, world 5 Pterodactyl Land. It's like a dinosaur theme with cavemen and stuff like that. And there's the relic I got to get for Chief Blodizen. But there's this guy guarding it. He is a member of the Unga Bunga tribe. And just like whenever I got that Jiggy from Slumber the Snake, this stuff is so difficult to sneak on. Like, watch. I'll try. It just takes forever. Let's see if I can do it. If I can't, there's kind of a trick to get over there pretty quickly. Steady. Steady. I'm nervous. I'm kind of shaking. Okay, I did it. I'm used to just doing the trick to kind of get over there really quickly. Because I always, you know, I'm used to playing this kind of like as a speed run type thing. Not a true speed run, but trying to race a friend of mine. Anyway, so we just carry this up. Come on, Banjo, so slow. Alright, and we will take it out of here. I got sidetracked. Oh, there we go. Take it back and make good old Chief Blodizen happy and get our Jiggy. Don't worry, it's still with me. For some reason, it just disappears once you get back in this thing. It's like it's just in my backpack. And this is another thing, if you can drop like right in front of him, there you go. See, it won't hurt you, it triggers the animation. Okay. Well, anybody who's watching this, I have yet to get any feedback in the comments about you know, what you would like me to do as far as the dialogue. If you want me to do voices, just read it normally, or shut up and let you guys read it yourselves. Gotta give me this feedback. I mean, if you guys are gonna be spending 30 minutes watching each one of these, then, you know, I wanna make it as enjoyable for you as I can. So let me know. Since there's not a whole lot of people on my channel right now, and there's not a lot of people watching, the few of you that are watching it kinda have some reins over it, so you can kinda help shape the thing. Anyway, get the Jiggy and get the heck out of here. Okay, see that thing in the middle, that pillar? That is Target Zan's temple. We'll go there last because that's where we will get the last couple Jiggies, and including fighting Target Zan. So. I still got to get a couple Cheeto pages in here, though, and I think another honeycomb piece, so I might try to do those first before I do the kickball. Yeah. Okay, let me show you something real quick. So, this is... Okay. We gotta open up this door by, you know, pushing these switches in a certain combination. And in there is where we'll get the last Jiggy for this world. But there's you have to learn a move in the second world that actually allows you to access it. So we can open up this door now, but we can't actually do anything else past that. The way you get the code for that is you have to talk to this guy here, but since I'm not a stony, he is of no help to me. But I played this so often that I remember a few different, there's only like 2 or 3 different codes for this, and so it could just be any of them. So I usually just try both of them. If I can remember it, let's see. I think it's One of them is sun, moon, star, moon, sun. It wasn't that one. Gosh, let's see. Star, sun, star, moon, moon, I think. Yeah, that's the other one. I think I have that one more often, but anyway, here's a little rat, Dilberta, looking for gold when that boulder fell down and trapped me in here. Does he expect us to move it? Yeah, if you wouldn't mind. Well, too bad we can't move it yet, you stupid little rat, because we don't have Buildrill, which is the move you gotta have, and you can't get that to a Glitter Gulch. So, you know, instead of being a lazy little rat trying to take a shortcut, you could, you know, I opened up your prison, you could just get the heck out of here and go home, but no. Always gotta rely on somebody else. And you know, actually, I am completely mistaken on that. I'm completely backwards. I don't know what the heck I was thinking. Yeah, we can't do that, that jiggy yet. Oh god, I forgot that thing was there. Okay, we can't do that jiggy yet. That part is true, but when we can do that jiggy, that counts as a jiggy for the second world. There is a... I'll show you here in just a second. There's a cheetah page here I want to grab first. Get up there. Cheetah page. Okay, so in here, this is the jiggy for this world. Same premise though. There's a boulder here that I don't have the move yet to break it. But anyway, once I do that, then I can get the jiggy for this world. Yeah. All right. Swim on out of here. You know, the swimming in this game really takes a lot to get used to. It's not the most fluid form of swimming that I've played in a game. And it's not bad. I'm used to it because I play this game so much. But... you know, I had my wife play this game, and she really had a hard time with that swimming. It's just one of those things where you get it or you don't. But Yooka-Laylee, they really kind of modernized the mechanics, and so the swimming is a lot easier in there. What am I doing? One of these days, I'll get the hang of playthroughs, recording myself playing and trying to talk at the same time. This is what you get for being a noob and trying to do this. Okay. I mean, we have these warp pads for a reason. I could have easily just warped here. Anyway, let me see what else I'm missing in here. I know the jiggies. Okay, I'm missing one Jinjo. He's inside Target Zan's temple. One honeycomb piece. I think the honeycomb piece is in Target Zan's temple too. Actually, no. Let me think. I got the one at the entrance, and then the one that was in Blodizen's place. Oh, the other one's over there by Bovina. I can't believe I forgot to get that one. Let's see. Okay, the other Cheeto page. Man, it's been a while since I've done 100% in this game. I think the other Cheeto page is in here. Because I believe there was one on top of the prison compound and on top of... This little room here is the code chamber. So you go to input codes, but we're not going to be using any of those. Okay. I already took his jiggy, so he's not going to wake up now. Yeah, there's the Cheeto page. Yeah, be careful of these guys. You gotta know when to actually attack. You get too close, they'll get you. Okay, that's all the Cheeto pages for this world. I'm gonna go grab that last empty honeycomb piece, and then it's off to kickball. And, man, I hope my patience is good. I hope I do well. It's been a while since I played the kickball. It's probably gonna be quicker if I go here. I need to go to Bovina. Right across this bridge here. That cow that tells the corny jokes. Yeah, there's the honeycomb piece up there. I don't know why I didn't grab it whenever I was here last time. I think I was... Guys, I am new to doing playthroughs, so... I am distracting myself by talking, but, I mean, I'm not going to do a playthrough where it's completely silent, because then it's just... I don't know. To me, it seems kind of boring. I always like playthroughs where... Well, I guess it depends on the mood I'm in. I mostly like playthroughs where people are talking, too, because they're either offering hints or tips on what they're doing, or they're just being entertaining. Maybe being funny or being angry or something that's entertaining. Which is, I mean, that's what I'm trying to be. I'd like to be entertaining. But if I'm not, then that's what the comments are for. Either let me know I'm doing a horrible job and that you'd rather me just play and not talk, or tell me to keep it up. All right, change into the Stony and waddle our way to kickball. All right. One thing I like about these games is that, like, each area you go to has its own, like, title, like, it has its own name. Each location does. And so, I guess that doesn't really matter which one I go to. So it's like, you know, whenever I was in that area, it said Jade Snake Grove. So it's like the map is so big that each area is named. I don't know. I kind of like that. A lot of people don't, though. I mean, I personally love this game a lot more than the original, Banjo-Kazooie. It's probably partly because I played this game first, so I'm a lot more nostalgic for this one. But that's not to say Banjo-Kazooie isn't a great game, because it's a wonderful game. I just prefer this one, but a lot of people think this one's way too complicated. They don't like the backtracking. They don't like that the worlds are just way too huge. You can kind of get lost in them. But I like that, honestly. I don't know. I like all the worlds being, like, connected and, you know. So you're a Stony, so he lets you in, but he's kind of suspicious of you because of the backpack and the shorts. He remembers them, but then he says, you know, they're short on players anyway, so he'll just go and let you go in. Training, we don't need to go down there. It's kickball. So talk to the Stony. Welcome to the Mayan Amateur Kickball Championship. You may enter the quarterfinals, but I advise you to take a little training downstairs first. I don't need it. I've played the game before. Deep breath. Gotta just score the most points by putting the balls in my own basket, in my own goal. Come on. It's like, did I forget how to play the game? Get out of my way. Get out of my way. Go in. Okay. That orange. It's not an orange ball. It's a yellow ball. No, go in. Okay. Oh, yes. Got another one right here. Out of my way, you little waddles. Okay. Well, I think I won this one. But that's easy. That was just the quarterfinals. Now we'll go to the semifinals. And of course, you know, they slowly get a little bit more difficult. They'll start adding, like, red balls, which when they're putting your goal, they take 1 point away, I believe. So you can kick the red balls into other people's goals, and there's black ones that are bombs. But this one, I think, just introduces the red, yeah. Oh, get out of here. Dang it, you jerks. Oh. God. No, get out of here. Stupid little stonies. Give me that. Nope. Hey, stay away from me. Okay. Yeah, you can waddle your ways down here, but I'm taking this ball. Get out of here, you stonies. Nope, taking it. Get out of here. Don't you dare charge at me. Okay, I pretty much got this one. I can just sit. Okay, now to the finals. When your semifinal, the Mind Kickball final beckons. Yep. That it does. Alright, let's go on in. Okay. I can't remember if it already adds the black, like the bombs in this one, or if that's not until the later one. I can't remember. Yep, there they are. There's the bombs. I cannot remember how many points they take off. Oh yeah. Two right in a row. Dang it, dang it, dang it, dang it. No, give me that. Oh God, are you serious? Get out of here. I don't know if that one counted for me. Okay, this one is way too close. Oh my God, I didn't even notice the purple one. Are you kidding me? Well, that really sucks. Dang it. I hate kickball. I really do. Yes, I'm playing again, of course. That's why I always try to focus on getting the balls in my goal instead of trying to take the points away from the other people. Because then the time you spend doing that, it just screws yourself up. Get that bomb out of here. Like, don't even. No, give me this yellow ball. Stay away from me, you jerks. Yeah, go down there. Stay out of my face. Oh, that's mine. Get out of here. Waddle yourself to another goal. Are you kidding me? That was the... Okay. These guys, you know, they stay in a pack. You know, nobody's getting that ball. But I'm getting this one. Okay. I'll let him waddle around. I got this. All right. So there's my Jiggy. I declare you the new Mind Kickball champion. Yeah, you do. I'm too choked up for words. Okay, give me that Jiggy. Let's get the heck out of here. All right. Warp to Wumbas. Turn back into Banjo. Get rid of this stupid stony. See what I mean? Like, that kickball, I mean, it's not hard, but it can be, because it's like you either gotta use the strategy of just trying to get as many balls in your own goal as you can, or start taking them away from the other people with using, like, the bombs and the other ones. The trick, really, which I should have done the first time on the finals, the trick here is just focus on your own place, your own goal. Don't worry about, taking points away from other people, because as you can see, by doing that, it just screws yourself up. But now the Coliseum, which is the Coliseum kickball, which is the one in that Hellfire Peaks, the gameplay is just a little bit different. So here we're in a first-person mode because we're shooting eggs around. Sacred statues, find your prize, yeah. So in here, we gotta get, show you. So we'll get Jiggy number 1 and 2. Defeat Target Zan and inside Target Zan's temple. The number 2, obviously, we'll get first, and then the second one we get, inside Targeted Zan's temple, we'll get that one first. And the one that says defeat Targeted Zan, obviously we get that last once we actually defeat Targeted Zan. And then the other things I've got left to get in here would be a Jinjo. Why did I go to that screen? Go back down to totals. Jinjo. Yeah, because I've got everything else. All right. So, first person mode. Yeah. You shoot all those things. We gotta get these little relic things. You gotta get a total of 20 of them to be able to go into Target Zan. To actually go into, like, his chamber. Alright. Out of here. Okay. Yeah, and this guy is a douche. I really hope I got all five of those. I'm pretty sure I did. There's like a, you know, secret ways you can do this stuff. Like if you're wanting to kind of speed run it. Yeah, yeah, he's behind me. But I'm not doing a speed run right now. I am obviously just playing a normal playthrough. So don't really need to worry about all the little tricks. But just if you wanted to know. Now this one, in this room, they're kind of like in, all the relics are, you gotta zigzag around to get them. Out of here. God. Things are so annoying. Mm-hmm. Get out of here. I need some honeycomb pieces. I am doing horrible. There we go. Don't talk and shoot, I guess. I need to get that Jinjo. I think it looked like it was a purple one. Yeah. Got two of those so far. Oh, get, no, stop. Jeez. Okay. Four more relics. Where are they? It's right here. Three. Of course. Where's that last one at? I get so turned around in here. I mean, you really gotta have a good game plan when you're coming through here. I mean, you can get those things super fast. So if you, I mean, if you're speed running, there it is. If you're speed running, I mean, you can pretty much memorize where those things are. I just don't really see any need since I don't do that. I don't do the speed run. Okay, well now we can go fight Targeted Zan, and that'll be it for this episode because that'll be the end of Mayhem Temple. Probably just go open up. Glitter Gulch, and we will start the next episode with Glitter Gulch. That should be fun. I like Glitter Gulch. It's a fun world. Target Zan is not difficult. I would like to ask myself what the heck I'm doing. Once again, classic case of me getting myself turned around. Good grief, I'm just going in the biggest circle ever. Okay. Yeah, this is where I need to go. Get out of here. Okay. So. Yeah, let me go in here and get this slightly sacred chamber. Just a freebie jiggy. Freebie jiggy. Sounds funny. Alright. Now, this little doorway right here, usually you come out that way. You don't go in that way, but since I didn't go the other way, I'm just going to do it backwards, but you can get a infinite egg. So it gives you 60 seconds of just non-stop egg shooting. So that's a good way to go start targets in. Get a good 40 seconds or so without having to worry about ammo. So this one is, tries to trick you before the boss fight ensues. I think there's another Jiggy. Another Jiggy, this is just too easy. Yeah, we'll have the game finished in no time. But, little did they know, boss fight. Target Zan. Halt, mortal. Thought you'd get another... Nah, I skipped it. I screwed myself over on that. I'm so used to keeping my thumb held down. I'm Target Zan, mighty Mayan god of target shooting. Prepare to meet thy dart-ridden doom. Okay. Shoot the targets. And then one level blows away. And then a Moggy comes up to try to get me. You gotta kill the Moggy. Avoid the darts. Another level. And there'll be a couple more Moggies. Okay. Okay. More Moggies. Come get me, worthless Moggies. Okay, come on. Wow, I actually got hit. Twice. Okay, now there'll be a Moggy at every station. Okay, back to regular eggs now. Self-destruct. Okay. Let's go get that Jiggy. Alright. That's all the Jiggies for this world. Now we leave. See if I can remember the fastest way to the exit. If you're doing the speed run, what you would do would be just to exit the game. Because it's actually quicker to do that and... get yourself taken back to the start of the world, or to the start of the game, and then it will take you to the start of the world. But could it be? No, of course not. For once, I thought I was actually gonna do it. I can never get back out of here super fast. It takes me forever. There we go. No. That's right. This is ridiculous. Okay. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Let's just hit exit game. Well, we need to do that anyway, because we got to go to open up Glitter Gulch Mine. This is quicker. And see, whenever you do this, it'll save it. Continue playing offline. Yeah. Play game. Where the middle save. Okay. Alright, actually, while I'm out here, what I can do real quick, since I have Grip Grab, there's a treble clef up here on top of this red house. You can't get it until you have Grip Grab. So let's go and grab it. Alright. On to Wooded Hollow. Go give Jiggy Wiggy these Jiggies, and you don't really give them to him. You kind of show him that you have them, and open up Glitter Gulch. It only requires 4. I think we could technically open up Witchy World as well. I think it only requires 8, but we're just doing one world at a time, so we'll just do Glitter Gulch now. Come on. Some of these things, they really trick you because they make them look so similar in color. Alright, there we go. Get the thumbs up. unleash the magic. And whilst doing that, I'm going to take a drink. If you heard that weird sound, I'd set my controller down on the table to get a drink. And during this part, the controller vibrates, it rumbles. And so that's what that is on the table. Alright, opened up Glitter Gulch Mine. And this is where this particular episode is going to stop. Yeah, see, he says I also have enough jiggies to attempt challenge 3, which would be to open up Witchy World. But anyway, I'm going to stop here. And yeah, we will continue on in the next episode, number 4. And that'll be starting Glitter Gulch. Anyway, once again, guys, let me know any feedback you've got. Let me know how I'm doing. Like I said, since this is my very first one, you know, obviously I'm not going to be as good as a lot of other Let's Players or whatever on YouTube that have a lot more experience. So go easy on me. But also don't. I also want to know honest feedback. If there's something I'm doing that you don't like, you know, talking too much, not talking enough, not explaining things enough, let me know, because I would like to correct it. I want to do what you guys would like me to do. And again, let me know about the dialogue stuff as well. Anyway, I thank you guys for watching, listening to me, and watching me play and fail miserably on some things. And please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And yeah, we will see you guys next time.